Welcome back. We are back to our next video, which is about shifting the curve in supply and demand and looking at how to restore equilibrium. So first we will be looking at our previous video where we looked at price change and restoring equilibrium. This is an example of restoring a shortage. So as we can see, we started with price equilibrium at PE and QE. When the price decreased, quantity demanded ends up being larger than quantity supplied. So we have a shortage. And the way that we restore equilibrium for a shortage is that consumers who think they will miss out will bid up the price. As the price increases, the quantity demanded will decrease. And remember that this follows the law of demand. As that price increases, the quantity supplied will also increase, following the law of supply. And then this process continues until the quantity demanded is equal to the quantity supplied, and we reach PE and QE once again. The other scenario we have looked at is when the price is above equilibrium. So when this occurs, our quantity supplied is greater than our quantity demanded. And so the firms will lower the price to clear excess stock. As the price decreases, more consumers can now purchase this product. So quantity demanded will increase. Both of those follow the law of supply and the law of demand. And this process continues until the quantity supplied is equal to quantity demanded and we reach equilibrium again. So just as price can change when we move up and down our y-axis, we can also shift the curves. So we can shift the demand curve and we can shift the supply curve. So in this example, this is an increase in demand, where you can see that the demand curve has shifted to the right. So a shift to the right is always an increase if we follow the axes along the bottom, the x-axis. And so once we shift our demand curve, we've got a new demand line there. Therefore, we are no longer in equilibrium. And at our original price at PE, if we continue to draw that line across where it hits our new demand curve, and then draw our dotted lines down to our new quantity demanded, we can see that demand is still again greater than supply. So we have a shortage. So the arrow between the two lines in the blue pen, that is identifying where the shortage occurs. The same can happen for supply. So if we shifted the supply curve, this is an increase in supply, it's shifting to the right. Same thing occurs at the original, so we always look at the original price line. At the original price, we draw the dotted lines across to where it hits the new supply curve, draw our dotted lines down. We can now see that our quantity supplied is greater than the quantity demanded. So where I've drawn the arrows between the two quantities in the blue pen, that is showing our surplus. We've got more than what the market requires. So the same thing would happen. Firms would lower their price to sell the excess stock, and this would cause the demand to increase, and this continues until equilibrium is restored. Now our new equilibrium is restored at a different price and a different quantity where the curves intersect. So we're moving from the original equilibrium to the second equilibrium because of that surplus.
And what do you label the second equilibrium?
So the second equilibrium is labeled Q1 in this example. It can differ, it depends on what your question is. So structuring your answers is really important. This is a good little step-by-step process on how to structure your answers. So no matter what the question is, you'll follow this process and you'll just adapt it through the details within your own question. So you're going to fully explain how the market, so the market is when consumers and producers come together, will respond to a change in equilibrium, and you do this by the following steps. So number one, first of all, identify whether it is a shortage or a surplus, and where the price has stayed at the original equilibrium price. Number two, you're going to explain how the consumers or producers will respond to the surplus or shortage and how this will affect the market price. So for example, if there's a surplus, producers will lower the price, increasing demand and supply. If there's a shortage, consumers will bid up the price, also increasing demand and changing supply. So that was number two and three. And then number four, you're going to continue this process, whatever it might be from above, until ultimately the market price will set itself at the new equilibrium point. So whether it is a shortage or a surplus, it's going to be the same result each time. Okay, so this is a practice question. So this is a practice question on page 130 in your blue learning workbook. As you can see here, I'll show you which book it is because we have two. So this book here on page 130. So this question is asking us, we're going to shift the demand curve. So I'm going to go through this question step by step with you in this video. So the first part of the question, on the graph below, show the effect of a decrease in demand by doing the following. Shift the demand curve, use dotted lines to identify new price and new quantity, and then add new labels in. Question B is fill in the gaps. So give it a go now if you wish, and then I will go through the answers with you. So AI, we have shifted the demand curve to the left, labeling it D1 or D dash. Okay, so a shift to the left is always a decrease because we have decreased our quantity along the x-axis. We always label it D dash or D1 because it's showing us that's the next consecutive change that we have made. And next question, AI. Asks us to use dotted lines to identify the new equilibrium price and quantity where the new demand curve and supply curve intersect. So, where the new demand curve has crossed over the supply curve, that is going to be our new equilibrium. Because remember, equilibrium is where demand is equal to supply. So that's where we're starting from. And I've drawn some pink dotted lines in there, creating a new equilibrium, and labeled it P1 on our y-axis and Q1 on our x-axis. So that is questions 2 and 3 completed now. For the next part of the question, B, we're filling in the gaps. So it's going to ask us what words to put in here. So fully explain how the market will move from the initial equilibrium price to the new equilibrium price by completing the paragraph below. So following the decrease in demand, so that is the curve that we've shifted to the left, at the existing price of PE, so if we still look on the graph and look at our PE on the y-axis, there would now be a surplus or excess supply. So the way that we can identify this, it does get a little bit tricky, but the key word here is at the existing price of PE. So because we've shifted the curve to the left, we use our PE price, go across, and where it hits that new demand curve, I've drawn a blue dotted line all the way down. You can see I've labeled that QD. So that is showing us that at the original price, that is our new quantity demanded. But what happens is that our supply is still over to the right there because the supply curve has not changed. So if I was to draw, keep going along where your PE price is, keep going past demand curve, where it hits your supply curve, go down. So it's labeled QE because it was the original equilibrium. But if we think about where it is now in comparison to our demand curve, it is actually the quantity supplied at that price. So now you can see on the x-axis, I've got a new QD and a new QS written in blue pen. And because our QS is greater than our QD, so supply is greater than demand, we can identify that gap as a surplus. Okay, so if we think about a donut shop, the donut shop has more supply than they do customers. Therefore, they've got a surplus. So back to our written answers. In response to the situation, producers will lower their prices in order to sell their excess stock. So the donut guy, he's going to lower his price to get rid of all those excess donuts. And then as those prices decrease, the demand's going to increase. More consumers are going to be willing and able to purchase those donuts at that price. So as the price decreases, the quantity demanded would increase, while the quantity supply would decrease until a new equilibrium price is reached. And now that new equilibrium price we can see is at P1 and Q1, where I've got that written in the pink. So we've just used this answer at the bottom to explain what has happened in the graph above. So we've talked about green, the demand has changed. Then we talked about blue, the surplus. Then we talk about the pink pen. So the pink is the end result. So in this answer now, this is exactly how you want to structure your answer. But additionally, you would add in all your graph coordinates. Okay, so that is an example of shifting the curve, identifying a surplus or a shortage, and then how equilibrium is restored. So whether it is an increase or a decrease in supply, you're going to do the same thing for each of your answers and structure your answers that same way. Hope that helps, and I'll see you next time.